day. After 5 p.m., we have talks, and after that, at 6 p.m., we have the car at the first floor to bring us to the party. Okay? Then, this is the last one. If you have any question and you have anything, just tell us, just tell the pink chair people. Okay, the last one is called Selling WordPress to Enterprise by Rahul from India. He has he run his company called TCAM. He worked with a big company in India and in Singapore and many companies that he introduced himself. Okay, please welcome Rahul.
Companies who are bidding much higher, and like 7 digits on WordPress. we're not talking money here, we're talking about the thing that drives that kind of people to the WordPress. So the point is they understand they are responsible for the whole thing. Our opinion is that, oh, I write those 5 lines of code, so I am responsible for that. Definitely that will help, but then you will get customer who will find you on Fiverr. You know, who is on $5 or $10. The people who need everything from you. If you expect them, okay, looks like core issue, not my 5 lines. Go and file it if you don't track. Oh, this looks like your SEO plugin issue, talk to yours. This looks like gravity pump issue, talk to gravity pump. That kind of attitude doesn't work with free clients. They need everything. And this is where the gap is. The way you understand this gap, the way you understand that you are responsible for the whole thing, your fix changes, your story changes. You don't look at thing you are providing. You are looking at what customer is getting. And customer is getting everything. This is the key transition in our journey. You need to realize at some point that WordPress is your product. Don't think that you are selling, don't treat yourself as a third party. Our community is very nice. I think nobody will sue you for this, treating WordPress as your own product. So we are very open. As long as you don't infringe on the trademark. But this is very important. The moment you realize you are responsible for everything, including hosting, your narrative changes, the way you talk to the customer changes. And that is the first thing enterprise expects. Because one of the things with big companies is that I don't like to work with many people. They're quite surprised. Big companies don't want to work with many people. Like there are big companies with like 100,000 employees. I am saying that they don't like to work with many people. It's like many outside vendors. Because they don't want to get into the blame game when the like Yoast is blaming RTCamp, RTCamp is blaming Yoast. They don't want to do that. They want, who are you paying? RTCamp? Yoast? Oh, we are paying to RTCamp. Then RTCamp is responsible for everything. They want to keep it in the core issue. They want to keep it in the hosting issue. And what is RTCamp's problem? Why RTCamp is not interested in giving us everything? Because it costs money, you will pay. We don't want $100 site, we will pay you like $10,000 on your retail account. But then we want everything from you. And when we talk about everything from you, so many things. Such a big ecosystem, 20,000 plugins. How you are going to provide support for 20,000? I think I underestimated the number is much bigger. And themes in WordPress.org, the third party. Theme repos, plugin repos, then custom code, hosting companies, plugin template. Just imagine mathematical computation and combinations of number of problems you can handle. So, we still can do everything. Let's take one by one. So, the first point was security. Like somebody asked, like, why if they don't consider WordPress as security? So, this is not a technical presentation. Just remember my whole narrative now on this. There are only two slides in white background in this presentation that reflect the two key takeaways. So, the moment you think like this, now how it changes. So, if I ask you security, what will be your attitude? So, if I come to you as a customer and say, hey, I heard WordPress is not secure, what are you going to do? What you are going to do? Any answer? If I come as a customer to you and say, okay, we can think about WordPress, but I heard it gets hacked, it's open source. How are you going to convince me? I don't know.
We take care of it.
Yes, we take care of it. That's a simple answer. Don't give me any jargon about use that plugin, use this company, use that thing. I'm your customer. Just tell me, you will take care of it. You make a promise to me, you set an expectation, and leave it up to you. Simple. How he will do it? I'm not my business. I'm paying him, my side gets hacked. and better for you. Because we are an enterprise, it's an illegal contract. Things won't get signed up over the emails. I will pay you a lot more money than the best WordPress themes and plugins could cost. More than what Cloudflare premium plan can cost. But I need assurance that you will take care of my security. It's not about technical things. They might have a CTO, that company might be inventing robot, that company might be Tesla itself. But they want to outsource one department, one responsibility that is not key to their business success. Similar to the scalability. Does it scale? I see WordPress is being used by many small sites. My next question. Again, I'm replying. What will happen if traffic increases? Will your code will fly with heavy traffic or will it crash? Yeah?
Probably give examples of sites with not more traffic.
Yeah, definitely that is important to convince me because I want to see who WordPress, like which are the big sites within WordPress. What else like? What are those big sites managed by you? Shall I go to those sites? Okay, so if you show me like a big site, then I will go to those people. Okay, so that means WordPress is scalable. What can you?
You match.
Yeah. So WordPress is your product. So you have, for a minute, just remove the WordPress from equation. So I'm coming to you. So his name is Rahul. So Rahul WordPress. And say there is a VIP, so automatic. So there's an automatic customer. So automatic has a VIP hosting which has like a very big name. And say customer comes to you and you want to offer your own complete solution end to end. And you are showing them VIP showcase. They will know you're VIP. Now that's a good thing for WordPress in both cases, WordPress thing. But how you will convince me? Stay with you. Maybe I will go to the VIP and say, oh, their pricing is too much.
But you already have some sites where whom you have scaled.
Again, the answer is the same. We will.
Yeah,
please.
Yeah, I would tell you not to worry.
Not to worry.
Yeah.
So we know those guys. We can take care of that hosting. So if you have good budget, we can host you with all the same server. So in the end, like, it's about us taking care of things. So the thing is, many times we think that there is too much to do if you have to deliver everything. Just remember, if you are starting a pizza shop, you don't have to start farming. You can buy toppings from market.
Curate.
Yeah, so it's like that. You need to curate your offering. You need to have that formula, the right things. Your customer won't ask you, are these homegrown toppings? I'm here only to have everything by first party. Same with the integration. Now, this is very challenging part because big companies become big over the time. So, like, it's unlikely you will walk in a big company's office tomorrow, which would be the first day of that company. Like, first day in total history. It's not like a subsidiary of an existing company. So, usually these companies have lot many technical things. So we are in 21st century. Okay, the internet was invented in last century. So we have beat it. We have too many old legacy systems to take care. For example, it could be a CRM. So while we are fighting about the best content form plugin in the WordPress space, we get clients who are not using any content form plugin. They use something like Marketo, Salesforce, and many things that they want direct integration. They have their own landing page and marketing automation software. So again, like integration. I'm using XYZ automation system. You're driving from my template, but I don't need that. I want you to come into my system. So what do you will do?
I know it.
If it's available, we will give it in the last cost. Otherwise, we'll fill it now. In both ways, you will get it. It's just a matter of cost. When we will be writing a proposal, we will factor in the cost.
Just take out what are my
pain areas, what are my expectations. Because when, once you miss one expectation, you end up with this kind of integration. So it's like many people, the moment like most WordPress agencies here, content form, their mind goes to like one of the form plugins. Like, so like same case with us, we have like agency license for private domains. Anytime we need to put a content form, we will put private because we already have like, and we have a lot of customization around it. But it would pay off you in long run to understand how this content form will be used, because in large companies they have very big support team, they might have a very big sales team, and not all those people will be going to log into the WordPress. I visually have, do you use any CRM? Like how this captured information will be used? And more often they say, oh, we use that CRM. Then no need to use private form, because that company already has a WordPress integration in WordPress.com directory. If not, we go to that company's, that CRM's company's website and check if they have a developer dog and we estimate the importance. Okay. We can build one for you and we can send data directly to the system. So like sometimes don't take customer on the face level. As in, I will give you like a small example. In one case, a customer came in, they gave us a requirement. We need a CSV export of all the leads captured on our website on daily basis. Good. What are you going to do? Oh, we need to import them into MailChimp. We can do that automatically. Does it work that way? Yeah. So like, they wanted to, so they sent a one-page document describing all the steps. 9 a.m. an email, CSV should come to our marketing at company.com email ID, and then from there we will use this and what are the fields should be there, everything was there. But they didn't wrote what they are going to do with that CSV file. We asked them, what are you going to do with CSV files? Oh, we are going to import it into MailChimp manually every day. You don't need to do that, there are web hooks. So we will send every captured lead automatically. And if you want conditional logic, so they had like checkbox. Would you like to hear back from us again? We will use the checkbox to decide which one to send and which one not to send. Same, like this was like integration goes one step ahead for extensibility. So they, every company has a laundry list of features, like this CSV example. They will have things that they want, and like this is the one garden I feel like. So you always say that. So WordPress is such a big ecosystem that you will have a plugin for everything. Okay, but I'm not loving on the app part. Only the first layer. I. It's again in the first person. Apple didn't build every app in the app. Similarly, as WordPress is your project, your product, you didn't build every third-party integration in the WP out there. But when you're pitching to customer, it's your job. I will figure out which plugins are maintained, high code quality, won't affect the performance. That's my job. But we have everything. Like we have almost everything. If there's not, we will do it. And then the scary part. This is where the customer really gets. Like so this is actually, I think, a propaganda against all the open source software by companies who are selling property software. They try to scare customers. Like you have to open source your source code, or all the themes, all the plugins. You have to basically put your source code in open, and anybody can demand source code of your website. That's right. So GPL doesn't force you to release source. What GPL says is, once you release source code, you cannot control how it is used. But if you keep it in your pocket, nobody is going to come to you and take it out from your pocket. But so we try to educate companies that we work with, that it is in good faith, it is good karma to not only release in open source, but it is commercially beneficial. So like if we release code in open source, it will get vetted by other people. So if we as a company make a mistake, it will get caught. You will get a better software over time. And the biggest point I'd say, because see, most often you end up talking to somebody in procurement whose key responsibility area is to say one, like, or they talk in numbers. So my vendor locking point is the biggest feature as concerned the GPS feature. That what if tomorrow your vendor decide to inflate the price? Next time they come for renewal, they say, we are not doing enough sales, the cost of living is going high, and we need to make 2x. So we are doubling our price. So all those uncomfortable pricing changes, you can skip your GPS and compare your vendor and still keep the software. What if your vendor says, hey, we are running out of, we are going out of business, we are shutting down, it was nice working to you, very emotional, nice email saying goodbye. What about the software? Oh, that's proprietary, you cannot touch it. In GPL, that's not the case. So, like, if you are, the way I say it, like, if you hire a party and tomorrow for some reason this is to exist, you can still code, keep everything. Like, you can keep WordPress, you can keep all those themes and plugins, you can keep all custom work and take it to the another vendor. And, like, even worse, like, we are there, but we refuse to work with you, maybe we ask more money that we don't want to pay, you can still take that out. Take away that and work with somebody else. So you are safe. In fact, in GPL, your freedom, as in this freedom, where your vendor won't talk to you. So I have also, one of the services we provide more is a CMS migration. People come with proprietary CMS and they are going to WordPress. So the biggest two reasons was the uncomfortable pricing changes and no updates. So like in our WordPress ecosystem, if you don't update any software for a year, nobody will renew, right? The customers won't renew your software if you are not giving support, won't update. But in proprietary world, companies ask money just for use of software. In 365 days, they won't give a small patch, not a single minor renew. And then their sales team will come to say, hey, it's year end, time to renew. So that doesn't happen in GPL. This is like a last point. It's free. That's another point here. So like, this is also, there's a mindset. Free means no accountability. What if something goes wrong? It's WordPress is my problem. I'm going to go. You don't have to read the news. Stop reading all the WordPress. I'm there. You ask me what you want. So if there is any second release, you will do it. And so like, a lot of many of our developers work in core. So try to say it like that. If there is any major issue, they will notice it on www.track if there is a public issue going on, and we will patch it before night. So again, accountability is simply, if something goes wrong, who is going to get responsible? I am your customer. So I come and buy a website from you, and tomorrow my website goes down for any reason, and I come and say, hey, that's free software. Talk about it. Maybe send them back to it. I don't care, like, not my job. So that is where you have to tell customer. So the way I put it, that's what they're charging for. They're charging for the accountability. It's not pretty still. They're charging for accountability. You may say, like, this is too much, like, security, scalability, integration, so many third party plugin. That's why we have partnerships. Together. Partner with hosting companies, partner with support companies, partner with design companies, like 60 people company and we don't have design. That's fine. At some point we realize that we are good at code. Let's focus more on code. So what if we are happy with the migration, but customer, oh, I need a new thing, new UI, UX, we are great with that. Wrong. But yeah, so 60 people we recommend. We don't have any objective, but we recommend these people. Them and we found them nice. So like, similarly, somebody goes to them and says, hey, the design is nice and we want to make it into a WordPress website. They might send us to us. So, final takeaway, what is the takeaway?
We are there.
You are WordPress.
You are.
Cannot remember everything, just remember your WordPress. It will remind you everything else. Because the day you realize this, you will stop blaming others. This is what I tell my group, right? They join our team. Everything is first party. This is our party, our bank. We have to take care of our guests. For everything. There's no issue that is not ours. Obviously, like this may not work in the product company domain because like, revenue per customer is really low to justify this kind of support. But like that's what we charge for. That's why enterprises pay thousands of dollars, tens of thousands of dollars for WordPress website. Like really, like sometimes. So we see page then those page builder kind of sites which sells like $5. Website builder, that's a whole different thing. So if you underestimate WordPress, then how are you going to sell it? That's it. Thank you. I was here last year also.
Talk to them directly.
but we want their code to be routed from your Flink. It's like billing proxy. Because in big enterprises, sometimes onboarding a new vendor takes more than a month. And it happens to us also, like sometimes client work with us, but they bill through the partner who connected to the client. And it's not for commissions, it's just like people are so busy to onboard a new vendor, they don't want to do that. Any other question? Yeah, please. Thank you all.